So then we will move on to the last, adhesive bonding. So last welding process I am going to teach you. Okay, so adhesive bonding. So thermoplastics, they are all, you know, welded using the processes I taught you in over 1 hour. So thermosetting polymers, the process what I taught you, hot plate or induction or implant, ultrasonic, vibration welding, and they are not really used for thermosetting polymers. Thermosetting polymers are all joined either by adhesive bonding or by mechanical fasteners. Okay. So adhesive bonding is also commonly used for plastics and polymers, nowadays even for metals, right. So the adhesive bonding, the principle works in a very simple, right. So it can be, you know, adsorptive. Adsorptive means, what do you mean by adsorptive? It's you form a very weak the force between the joints to be made. Okay, so there can be chemical bonds. Okay, and or create an van der Waals force between the adhesive and the interface to be joined. Okay, so that chemical bond is mostly in covalent bonds. So adsorptive or like, you know, you have a glue in your school days, right? You always carry a glue bottle, isn't it? So those glues, though they create a weak van der Waals force by forming an covalent bond between the adhesive and to the interface to be joined, right. So generally the adsorptive forces are weaker. Okay. So we can also make slightly stronger joint by making an electrostatic joint. Okay. So electrostatic joint, generally they create an ionic bonds. So ionic bonds between the interface to be joined and with the adhesive you are welding. Okay. The strongest bond you make, right, that is by the diffusive. Okay. So diffusive joints means generally the adhesive we use, the molecules diffuse to the polymers to be joined, and you make a single diffusible layer at the interface between the adhesive and the fraying interface. Okay, so diffusive joint means result of a complete molecular chain entanglement between the fraying interface and the adhesive. Okay, so the most of the common adhesives we use, they are all adsorptive. We make a weak covalent bonds or a dipolar using a van der Waals force. So the electrostatic and the diffusive joint, these are three major mechanisms by which we develop the adhesives. So by having a diffusive bonding, it's the best we can have, okay, but it's very difficult to achieve. So most of the cases, if you have an electrostatic with an adsorptive joints, that's okay. The main important characteristic of adhesive is the wetting. Okay, so the wetting angle should always be less than 60 degrees. If it is more than 60 degrees, so then it is not advisable to use that. So the wetting angle should always be less than 60 degrees. Otherwise, it is not going to wet the surface. Yeah. So the important characteristic of adhesive, that should be the contact angle, the wetting angle should be less than 60 degrees, right? And then it should work in this principle. We always aim for diffusive joints, but most of the adhesives they fall into these two categories. It's clear? Adhesive bonds. Okay. So how do you classify the adhesives? We can classify in various ways. It's a chemical type or a physical forms or cure mechanism, how you cure that, or a function, right? So the chemical types, you know, it can be natural polymeric components, okay, inorganic materials, or synthetic polymers like thermoplastic, thermosetting, elastomers. So nowadays we have all the high temperature glues, then those are all thermoplastic. Okay, materials you heat up and then deposit, it becomes hot extrusion. The process we saw extrusion joining, right? So you melt and then extrude the thermoplastic filler onto the joining interface, right? In physical forms, it can be liquid, pastes, flames, foams. Okay, so we can use, and the cure mechanism is very important. So you can also classify the adhesives based on the curing mechanism, you know, by chemical reaction, okay, or a moisture cure. You need to add some water. Anaerobic means you need to cure with an absence of air. You need to create a vacuum so that it cures, okay. And you can also melt, hot melts, hot guns, for example, or by light, phototherapy, okay. So you can have an UV lamp, and then UV reacts with the polymers, and then the molecular entanglement can take place by the induced UV reaction. Or you can also use microwave. Microwave curing also can be done, or you can also do pressure heat cure. And you can also classify based on the functions, adhesives, if adhesive used for joining alloys, okay. So, or you can, that is used to join dissimilar materials or dissimilar materials with the metal and the polymer. So, you can classify based on the function as well, right? It's clear? Good. Quickly move on. So, in the adhesive process, curing is very important. So, curing can be done, as I said, in various processes. So, by chemical reaction or moisture or by light. In most of the cases, the curing is done either with light or with heat, okay. So, in all these processes, the curing is achieved by heating above or by curing above the glass transition temperatures, okay. So, for example, this is a curing time, and this is the characteristic of the various reaction that is possible in adhesive, okay. So, for example, crystalline and becomes glass transition, and then you have an melting, okay. So, generally the curing is done above melting and then below the degradation temperature, okay. So, this is the optimum cure zone, okay. So, yeah, if you go above degradation zone, and then you are going to vaporize, you know, you are going to burn your polymer, okay. So, this is the glass transition line, gelatin line. The curing is done. So, in the temperature in the isotherm of liquid, and then below degradation temperature. And the curing time can be reduced by applying pressure or by using in a subsequent reactions, like in a chemical reactions. You can also promote the curing, right, so by chemical reaction as well, okay. So, yeah, it's one of the common commercial adhesive. It works at room temperature because it has a chemical reaction, triggers curing, right, because you can't, you know, heat up all the time, okay. So, most of the commercial adhesives used for simple application, household applications, and they work at room temperature by chemical reaction, okay. Good. So, joint designs, the most commonly used joint design is a T-joint or corner joint, or you can also do T-joint, corner joint works perfectly. So, when you want to do a flat sheet adhesive joining, you always have to do it in overlap configuration. So, you need to have a proper lap distance, and this is not advisable, okay. Or you can also double butt lap, okay, joggle lap. So, generally adhesive bonding is not done in a plain butt, or you can also do double jab in this configuration or in another way. And again, so this is also very commonly used, double strap, okay, and the beveled double strap, right. So, adhesive bonding is coming in a big way, especially, you know, material the alloys that are used now in automotive industries are become extremely complex in microstructures. So, when you use a fusion welding process, you destroy the microstructure, but the problem with adhesive bonds is the weight. You always add extra material, okay. So, you increase the weight. So, unless we invent something, you know, which can work in a very small dimensions, you have a very nanometer layer or micrometer layer of adhesive which actually works the job, then you can, it's okay. Otherwise, the weight gain you aim for, it may not be achievable by using adhesives. And adhesive joints are always poorer than, in terms of mechanical properties, poorer than the fusion joints. But in some of the applications where you don't need and a good mechanical property or crash performance, we can use the adhesive bonds. Good. Some of the joint designs I gave, these are also commonly used for automotive applications. double scoff, step lap, double step lap, tongue and groove, and right angle butt. You can just refer it from the slides. So, what are the advantage applications of adhesive bonding? In a polymer specifics, for cosmetic containers, lighting, and optical components, sporting goods, shoe. So, it is a classic example, isn't it? Adhesive bonds, office equipment, toys, automotive parts, and aerospace applications are also very widely used to join dissimilar alloys, okay, adhesive bonds. So, advantage is the efficient, economical in joining up dissimilar materials, very versatile. It is lighter than mechanical fastening, okay. But disadvantage is the joint degrades over time, right. So, because the polymer degrades much faster than metals, right, alloys, and the surface preparation is extremely important, okay. So, if a surface preparation is not done properly, if joints are done properly, you are not going to get good welds. It is extremely messy. So, we have adhesive bonding unit, okay. You will have to use it only in a closed container, because if you make a mess, you cannot clean it, okay. So, it becomes extremely messy and you need expensive cleanup, and it is also hazardous. So, adhesives when they use, they are all carcinogenic most of the cases. So, when you are curing, the vapor generated and it can affect, yeah, okay, good. So, I think that is it. Any questions so far? So, what are the things we saw in this class? Lot of things, right? Well, the principles of this process are very simple. Like, you know, if you look at the hot plate, hot tool, right, the vibrations, the extrusion process, ultrasonic, okay, and then adhesive bonding. So, these processes are commonly used for polymers, right. So, the principle we already discussed, for example, ultrasound using vibrations by friction. Adhesive bonding, you know, mainly used for thermosetting polymers, right. So, we use three principles: adsorptive, electrostatic, or diffusive. Reactions to make the joints using adhesives, and based on the type of adhesives, we can classify them into, like, you know, the physical form or chemical type, a curing mechanism, or with a function. Yes, so we will end up the processes.